What's going on, everybody? So, I found out something pretty damn important today, and I wanted to get something done really fast and see what I could get done really fast tonight. So, I need free safeties, probably. Safety. And you probably, let's actually go right outside linebacker for you. And for you, it's going to be end. And for you, it's going to be, oof. Go outside linebacker again. There isn't anybody there. So I didn't know that. I had no idea that I needed to set those. I really didn't know. We're gonna get a couple games in, maybe. Minimum of one. Okay. Minimum of one. Probably max two.
James now throwing to start the drive. Throw left side complete. That's Vaughn. They'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. On second down, it's Vaughn. 7 yards there at a first down. Operating from the gun, James. They'll find Everett there, complete. So the completion good for 6 yards, and that'll make it second down. The Bears at 0-2 here to begin the season. And listen, they made their share of mistakes in these first two games, CD, but yeah, talking with them in the days leading up to this one, doesn't seem like they've lost any confidence.
I would agree with that. And what they told us was that they weren't planning on making any drastic changes. They didn't see the need to shake things up. They were going to continue to plow ahead. They've got the right guys on the team and in the locker room. But they do have to start winning some games.
Vaughn on first and 10. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front. Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner.
Touchdown, Chicago! So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. They start the drive with ball.
Oh shit.
And he's gonna lose yardage here back
my fault.
To the 14-yard line.
Completely my fault. I did the wrong thing.
There on the first down play.
Overall, I'd have to say that was just really good team defense because to me, you can't pin that one on the running back. He had no shot there. He had a man in his face immediately.
Now James looking to throw on second down. And he gets this one just short of the 35 and the 34. First catch for the man leading the NFL in receiving yards of this first month. And a first down to boot. A first carry for Rashad White. Takes it to about the 37.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run it, try and keep the defense honest.
Maybe or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down.
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
Let me see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve.
they become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends.
First down. First down again.
14 yards in a Chicago first down. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now. That's that good arrogance. Believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
Now, quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete. Here now is second and 10 again for the 41. The play fake, James.
Oh.
And that is incomplete.
Well, you got a receiver here. He's got one touchdown already this first quarter. They were trying to double his pleasure there. Wanted to continue to go to the guys. Already gotten into the end zone. But good coverage to make sure that this time it fell incomplete.
It's been a pretty long drive. This will be play number 9. And they need 10 yards out of it on third. Blitz forthcoming as he'll look to throw. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Final 30 seconds of this first quarter. It's been a quarter dominated by the guys with the football. Back to throw again. Looking middle, and that's complete. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. Again, he'll drop to throw. He's got his man. That's Everett, the tight end. Back in Chicago, ready for the second quarter. It's the Bears in possession as they go to work on a first and goal.
Nothing dumb.
Here's White.
Holding. I just said nothing dumb.
He starts to slip off of you, and instinctively you reach out and grab him. And when it's done like that, it's often seen by the official.
And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal.
Oof.
White will struggle to get to the line of scrimmage as he'll be tackled back at the 4-yard line. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
I think we got to give it up for him right there. That's a heck of an athletic move for a big man right in the middle of the line. How about the play he makes there? Nowhere to run, and he finishes that one off for a loss.
Again, this is White, and he's going to lose yardage again as he is stuck.
Yeah, on you.
Not at all what they envisioned on third down, 3 yards in the wrong direction.
I'd rather get the 3 points than not score.
Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort.
Right? That's all right.
That's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. That's taken in by Duvernay. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A gain there of 21 yards. Here's James on first and 10. Complete.
There you go, Washington.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards. Fake here on first down. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end Everett. And he'll be taken down at about the 22 yards.
position to be in here, second and inches. Out of the gun, it's a give to Vaughn. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And that would also
that was accurate as hell.
Incomplete. Gerald Everett is tight end, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
But that's a defense coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
James, going to throw again. It's grabbed over the middle by White. And they're going to be set up now with a ball at the 13-yard line.
It's all right. Just need another touchdown here. You can do this.
So it's third and six, and this will be the eighth play of the drive. Back to throw. James. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Try and run it with White, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. So back to live action. Let's see what this offense can do here on this play. To throw is James. Throwing to start the drive. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
Well, second down pass play there.
That was so close.
Confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown, but incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
James now on third down.
And this dude, that's right there. You have to complete that.
The third down stop that they needed because they've had a lot of trouble slowing down this offense in the first half. This might be their opportunity to get off the field.
Call it 46 yards on the punt, just a single yard on their own 34-yard line. So we are in the final minute now of the first half as this offense gets ready to take over. Now James on first down.
I'm sorry, what? How did he just...
Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Here's James to throw on second down. The 40 before he's out of bounds. 23 yards on the tuck and run. James throwing on first down. And he'll be brought down just
right
shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. So we come upon halftime here at no break needed. Let's get back to it. Week three, here we go with quarter three. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. So this a two-possession ball game as we get back underway, set for the third quarter. This taken in at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. On first and 10, James. He'll find a man over the middle. It's Washington. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Up the middle, it's Vaughn.
I'm sorry, what the fuck was that?
There on the first down run, he'll get a couple, and that's it. Second and 8. Off play action, James. Throw left side, taken in by Washington. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. So for Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 46. Looking to throw, James.
I don't know what button I hit. I fucking knew it.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Yeah, last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive.
I don't know if it was because I held down the X button.
7 yards there at a first down.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that plan any down.
They go play action here on first down. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. He's got a man complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Back now here on EA Sports. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
That was well defended. They clamped down on every available receiver. Just got to give the win to the defense on that snap.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Working the middle here. That's complete to Everett, the tight end. He's down inside the 10 to the 8. And it comes on a gain of 8. They'll try to run for it with Vaughn. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. So the football will be 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. To throw is James. Throwing to start the drive. And down he goes. A Buccaneer sack. We've seen him escape similar situations earlier in the game and get away from pretty good yardage. At that time, they get him down.
Yeah, they've had enough evidence that he can get away and run for good yardage, haven't they? That time it felt like, okay, enough of this. Let's play it the right way and get him on the ground before he does any damage.
A gain there of 21 yards. James now on first and 10. This one swung out to Vaughn. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. More muscle up front for this second and 2. They've got 3 tight ends out there. Running behind center with Vaughn. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1. On third down, it's Vaughn. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Back to throw. James, that's complete to the tight end, Everett. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. Now James, looking to throw on second down. They'll find Vaughn complete. Vaughn lost the football. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers. But he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down here. Offense ready to go for their next drive. Well, they can smell victory, partner. They can see it on the horizon, but certainly we're not done yet. Your defense still has 3 timeouts, and obviously this is a very slim lead they're holding.
What the?
And let's face it, the easiest way to get this done, challenge your ground game, challenge your offensive line, your tight ends, your receivers, anyone who's going to lay down a block. Don't let there be penetration because they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and maybe bring extra people to the ball. If you can do that, make them burn their timeouts, run out the clock, life will be good. But if you really want to gamble a little bit, a quick play action, quick throw,
Might be able to get it done. Just make sure it's not incomplete and stop the clock.
Here's James, off play action, and he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Here's Lachlan Edwards now, as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. This will be fielded at the 17. A nice return there of 11 to help mitigate a good. Complete to Ebron, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Herbert gonna throw. This one into the hands of Aguilar.
Fucking stupid.
This is this all the way down inside the 35. First down now, but that clock rolling. To the right side to Eric Ebron. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Clock running, the Bucs trying to go quickly and get set. Now Herbert, and it's throw incomplete. Defender all over at that time. It's going to lead to third down. They'd love to get a little closer if they need to kick the field goal on fourth down. From this spot, it's 46 yards. Herbert to throw, and it's nearly intercepted. Probably should have been. Had he caught it, it would have sealed it instead. One more chance coming up on fourth down. Rosas' kick is good, and that will tie this game here in the final minute of play. So a big kick to get this back to even, yet now the worry is, did you leave too much time on the clock? Because another field goal the other way, and that does you in.
You're exactly right. You didn't get it to overtime yet, so now as a defense, you've got to think to yourself, you can't play prevent defense, just give up big chunks of yardage in front of you, but you also can't let anyone behind you. So you sit right on the line between the two, play the best defense you can, and not make it easy for him to move the ball downfield.
James throwing to start the drive. He's got a man complete. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 ticks remaining on the clock. To throw is James on first down. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone.
Let's fucking go.
He got it. It's a touchdown. Forget overtime. They're going to win the football game right now. Extra point up and through. They will take a 7-point lead. The long touchdown pass gets him 6 on a very, very tiny 2-play drive. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And with time a factor here late, we'll just take a knee, and they'll start things out at the 25. Now Herbert. He's going to let it fly. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. Herbert. Oh, he forces one there. It's a potential dagger as it's intercepted. And the Bears are going to hang on. They get the turnover to seal this football game. What a ball game this was. What an atmosphere this was in the home team.
Hell of a game. Hell of a game. Okay, we're gonna wait on that one. Because all players fitting the scheme would be tremendous. I guess they are 0-3, so I should have won that game. Oh, oops. Forgot to do my split. So far, I mean, that was about as complete a game as I could have asked for from the defense, especially. Isn't he the one who picked off the ball in the last fucking play? I think I'm going to leave. I think Duvernay might be better at that spot, though. Because if he can take off, so he needs to be slot. Because what's happening is the slot wide receiver spot is pulling him away. Yeah, needs to be like that. He has a tag called Award Winner. What's that? Manage roster. Rosters. What's that mean? Teams are more interested in this player during free agency. No income tax. Progression history. Six receptions, one touchdown, seven receptions, 186. So really, he didn't fall off in that spot. I mean, that one huge catch. Okay. Is this the point where I pick three? No. Okay. That's fine. Okay, we're going to try not to get cocky. We're going to play the same game that we've been playing. Yeah, they got some weapons. So this is probably going to be a loss, but positive. Just push forward. I should have taken their stadium. That would have been good.
James now, off the bootleg. And he fires one that's intercepted.
As soon as I threw it, I'm like, somehow he's going to intercept that.
It's all right. Set to take over. Okay, Duvernay, you might be able to beat this.
Try to shake off the interception. He'll
nope.
To throw.
You would have. You definitely would have.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29. A gain of
switch sides.
To throw on second down. James.
Fucking A. Dude. Get that shit off my screen.
What you're going to see from this offense is that they love the matchup with their wide receivers against this secondary. That one wasn't successful, but don't expect them to back away from attacking all game long.
Now James to throw on third down.
Come on, fuck on, come back. I'm literally pulling back so that you come back to get the ball.
Set to take over. Here's James throwing to start the drive, and that was going to be off target and incomplete. This defense for the Dolphins, they were fantastic a week ago in that win over Houston.
And what keyed their victory? The pass rush. Got to the quarterback six times for sacks, and plenty of other turbulence in the pocket for him as well. Hard to throw the ball downfield, but all you're seeing is opposing jerseys come at you.
His first catch, good for 14 there, and a first down. Looking to throw, James, and that's complete to his running back, Vaughn. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Got an open man, it's Washington. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 41-yard line. James, off the play fake. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. The Bears are 1-2 through the first 3 weeks of the season. And they got off to the tough 0-2 start, but come off a very important first win of the season last time.
Damn it.
And it's tough when you find yourself in an early season crossroads, but that's exactly where they were. At 0-2, they were thinking, if we fall to 0-3, things can spin out of control. But now at 1-2,
intercepted. Nope.
Shouldn't feel the need to press out there. They're now back in a good spot. Find a way to win some games and keep moving forward.
Here comes the seventh play now in this drive as this is 3rd and 10. Back to throw again. A little short. And now a fumble. The ball's out. Is picked up by the Dolphins, and the return out shy of midfield.
How's he fucking fumble that?
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. The drive starts with a run.
Holding. Not a fucking bet. On who?
So that time they got the left guard with a hold.
And let's face it, in today's ball, you might have that 330-pound guy you're supposed to clear out of there. You might need a little bit of extra help by grabbing the jersey and trying to ride him out.
And he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. Second down, they'll run with White. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. First down, here's White. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring us to the end of the first quarter. The Bears with the football. We get set to begin quarter number 2. As they've got it with a 2nd and 4 coming up. Switch it up here and look to throw. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, he's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10.
He's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. They keep it on the ground right again. And he'll get this down close to a first down at about the Dolphins 42. This offense so far on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. They'll try to pick this up on the ground with White. And it was the stiff arm there that freed him enough to get the first before he's tackled. They're able to convert with a gain of 4. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. A run with Vaughn out of the gun. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. Here's a handoff to Vaughn, and he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. Vaughn on the handoff, and he'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 2 minutes gone by, 2nd quarter. Vaughn on 1st and 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6. They will run with White out of the shotgun. And he's able to get it down.
I don't fucking care. This is what I have to do. This is what I have to do, I guess.
Down conversions. They need a yard here. They didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1. White.
Jesus.
And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. A loss of 2 there. 2nd down.
Well, I know defensive coordinator is going to be pretty excited by what he just saw there. Great knockback by their front. And now with the ball where it is, I would expect to see the offense throw the ball on 2nd and 3rd down here.
So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, 2nd and goal. They'll try and run it in with White. And he's into the end zone.
Yeah, he deserves that touchdown. On defense. Damn it.
So the offense set to take the field here. They will have the football with less than a minute to go in the first half. The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down.
Are you guys fucking kidding me?
Coming up now on a 2nd and 15 following that sack. Back to throw. James.
This game wants to screw me over right now. How many offensive linemen have I fucking lost just this game?
Going to take their 2nd timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. The Dolphins taking over now late in this first half.
Jesus.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this.
I'm honestly not sure what to do because.
To throw is James, throwing on 1st down, and nowhere to fit that football in.
I've literally thrown nothing but incompletions.
This is 2nd and 10. Off the play fake, James. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time.
That's not even into a zone. That's not even into a zone.
So the football. 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. That's complete. It's Devin Duvernay. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Now a play fake here on 1st down. And he slings one that's incomplete. Throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%.
Right, yeah, no shit. I didn't have whatever his name is, Watt in my fucking face.
You know those guys watched him all week. Saw how
precise he was and constructed a defense to try and chip away at that, and thus far they've been successful.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. They'll look to throw again. And this is going to fall to the ground, incomplete. That very nearly their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down. Again, he'll drop to throw. Here's White. They set up the screen. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. So now it's third and 10.
Screw it. Duvernay, you got to get open, dude.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. That's going to be complete to his tight end, Everett. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 15-yard line. Touchdown, Bears! Samori Toure.
Got to do something, boys.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. James now throwing to start the drive. He'll check this one down to Vaughn. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and it'll be second down.
Third man.
Off play action. James.
Look at that shit.
Forced out to his left. Looking left sideline. It's complete. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Looking to throw. James.
Intercepted. Oh, Duvernay came and grabbed it.
And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35. So the Bears with a football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Back to throw. James. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. They run straight ahead here with White. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. Now James to throw on second down. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone. Frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown.
Yeah, I kind of knew that was coming. That defense is tough as nails. And I had how many offensive linemen go down? That was crushing. Like, completely just steamrolled my ass into next week. I don't know who they lost to, but their offense must have been really fucking good. All right, who's ready to negotiate here? Millar, you're not really playing all that much. You're not playing at all. You guys are both 26, 25. What's your... You're supposed to be fast, but you can't get away from anybody. I really would love to develop you. I just don't know. And then you, fast again, but your release sucks, and you're 5'10". I just don't think
I don't think you're going to work out there, bud. Why isn't my tight end starting? Like, do I need to get him more reps? Five rushing touchdowns, my ass, dude. I'm just trying to understand why he's not playing. That other guy's good, but he's supposed to be an instant starter, so where is he? At least I'm finally starting to get upgrades for some linemen. Have you gotten any sacks at all? Well, there's one. I think the preseason one I got. Yeah. He just hasn't done what I needed him to do. I'm not gonna lie, I kind of like white a little bit more than I do. And you need to play. Where the hell is Whitehead at? Huh? What position are you? You're right tackle. Why weren't you starting? Why was he starting? Ay, ay, fuck. 2-2. One more. Then I'm done. I have a bad habit of saying that. Cameron Hayward, Jonathan Allen, Kyle Pitts. Okay.
Start to drive with White, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up,
and that's frustrating for a defense because they've got him pinned down deep, and on the first play, they gave up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about next all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
The middle with White. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21. The numbers for White a week ago. 12 carries, 56 yards, and a touchdown.
And now that he's playing a Thursday night game, short week, you know he spent a lot of time in the trainer's room in the cold tub trying to get his legs back for this game.
Opting to run again here with White.
That's all right. That's a good run.
25 to the 26, a gain of 5. For the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on third down.
Douglas, I need you, bud.
the play fake. James. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Douglas. And he will have the Bears.
I need to look at something here.
Okay, there. Yep. Look at that. Look at Torrey break open. If I lob that out left, he's gone, I think.
A couple of yards, he's able to convert here on 3rd and 3. Off play action, James. That is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down. Ball on the 30 as they come up 2nd and 10. Play fake, James. Going down the middle and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 23 yards to pick up there.
Well, from their point of view, this game could not be starting out much better, could it? Force a punt on defense, and now they're moving it crisply on offense.
Crisply, I like that.
Yeah,
moving it very, very well. Looks like the defense on their heels a little bit. You put a score in here, long way to go, but you're right, that's a heck of a start.
Yeah, and I think this is what Duke Hall is looking at his play sheet and saying, drop that dagger play, drop that play, and just finish them off right now, because I think they'd love to get that big advantage on it.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Off play action, James. And this is caught.
Oh.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They go play action here on 1st down. He finds Douglas complete. Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Off the play fake, James.
That's ugly.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass.
So many things have to go right for any passing play to work out. Quarterback has to understand the defense delivering out.
Again, it just that felt
somewhere along the assembly line, something was off.
On 4th down, here's Lachlan Edwards to punt it. Back deep, the former All-Pro Tyler Lockett. Call that a 46-yard punt there. They did get 9 back. So this offense will head back out there. They're in excellent field position after the fumble recovery. They defer to White out of the shotgun. Now this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on 1st down. They stay on the ground with White. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. Here's James on 1st and 10.
Oh.
Intercepted. Picked off by Kelvin Joseph. And the Colts are going to take over. Good punt. This offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll need to throw. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 10-yard line. James looking to throw on 2nd down. That one goes for 8 yards. Bears at 1-3 here in the early part of the year. But Charles, they were losers last time. What do you think they need to do differently here?
I don't think it needs to be as drastic as burning up last week's game tape or not watching it, but the attitude has to be what's done is done. Let's move on. Put that one behind them.
galvanize themselves and go forward and get a win in this one.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll take this forward for about 5 as we have come upon the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to play in this first half, 7-3, our score. To throw is James from the gun on third down. He's gonna launch.
You gotta be fucking kidding me. You set your feet and that's a touchdown.
Brock Edwards now to punt it away.
Damn it.
The coverage holds him to just. So we are in the final minute now of the first half as this offense gets ready to take over. James now throwing to start the drive. He finds his man complete. It's Douglas. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. The
last I got locked in on one guy.
Second and 9 from the 26. Operating from the gun, James. Got a man and he hits him in stride. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half.
Nope.
Now James on first down. Completes it to Douglas. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. His throw caught at about the 5.
Get the fuck out of here.
The offense will burn their third and final timeout. They will have time on the horizon. They'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle.
Yeah, I am not.
And his kick is good.
No, I want points.
Lead up to 4 now at 10-6. So a long drive gets him down inside the field goal. This offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter. Here's James, throwing to start the drive. And incomplete.
I don't like.
But you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those, but the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
James, off play action. That's taken in by Duvernay. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. To throw is James, throwing on first down, and he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
But based on the play we just saw there, he might not be the guy you want to challenge in coverage on these all-important snaps. He certainly looks dialed in right now.
Now it's all right. Left side into the hands of his tight end, and he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line.
Washington.
Out of the gun now on third down. Now the ball comes loose. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right
recent
to the plays.
Football.
This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for that the game. And you've probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. And he is going to have the Bears first down as they wind up with a gain of 11 there on fourth down. No question that they're going to continue to look his way. 6 catches in the first half and now 7 on the game. So now following the roll of the dice, they've got a 1st and 10 inside the 35. And he'll manage to pick up about 4 in second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, this is the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. On third down, James.
No fucking way, man. Why? Why? I'm holding right bumper to cover the ball. Fuck.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. James now on first and 10 to the right side and complete to Washington. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice.
There he goes, left side. Touchdown.
Finally. Chicago. Fucking finally.
Second year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie. Because usually.
Now the offense back out onto the field as he'll take over here in the final minute of this third quarter. Now James throwing to start the drive. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
The quarterback got away with one there. Looked like he was in line for a pick, but instead, it's knocked harmlessly to the turf.
Here's James, throwing again on second and 10. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. That first down there on a pickup of 25.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try to put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Yeah, he'll get what he can up the middle, 3 yards, and that'll bring up second down. James to throw on second down. And he's going to lose
fucking nothing.
As they will switch ends as time is running out on this third quarter of play. Back now here on EA Sports. The offense on third down tonight, just 1 for 5 to this point. This Shit. Will be 3rd and 19. Off play action, James. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. 3rd and 19, no problem as they're able to convert.
Stand aggressive on offense, because to me this drive is what is known as a put away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43. 2nd and 5. Looking to throw, James. Washington with a catch, middle of the field. They're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. I don't want to make a story where there's not one, but he threw the 3 interceptions last week. Looked a little uncomfortable. He looks much more comfortable today.
Yeah, just 1 pick so far, and his team leads. So now they can play complimentary football, meaning if he takes care of the ball and his offense, you know, they're humming.
Damn it.
The defense doesn't have to be out there as well. He's taking care of his guys on the other side of the ball.
Enjoying a fourth-quarter advantage. To throw is James. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions. Have them looking at 3rd and 10. Back to throw. James. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And they move this all the way down to the 9. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Good chance now to put this game on ice. This is 1st and goal. James now from the gun. He'll throw.
Oh.
But that's going to wind up incomplete.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one. Closed quickly. And he'll force the incompletion.
Another shot from the nine on second and goal. Looking to throw. James. Got his man and it's caught. Stages of the game here in the fourth quarter as his offense takes over first and 10. Now James off the play fake. Washington's got him. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Here's James off play action.
Come back and get it. Fuck. Wait, what?
Line prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Tie game.
Oh no.
We're likely headed overtime.
What I would do is either hand it off inside or more likely I take a knee and let the clock run out. Because if I'm back there trying to throw and a sack happens, the ball comes free, I can lose the game here.
How the fuck?
And here in overtime.
So they recovered the onside kick.
Scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball that gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
So it's the Bears who will have the first chance to win this thing as we are underway here in overtime. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. James.
No.
Oh, and it's intercepted. And the Colts are going to take possession of the football. That was an excellent come from behind victory, Charles, especially there in the fourth quarter.
How he just I got nothing. I don't fucking know how he just fucking threw that directly to that linebacker is beyond me. I really don't know. I'm trying to understand. I had the ball first. They have two really good defensive linemen. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to throw it. I ran that play 1,000 fucking times. And maybe I should have just thrown it away. I don't know. That is frustrating beyond belief. That I have guys like this still on my team. Fucking 59 overall backup.
I will say White has been a pretty damn good boost. Obviously, you guys know who my top target is. He's only allowed one sack and 243 downs. Him and this guy are the only two that have started every single game. He's gotten, I mean, compared to the first year, it's well, hell of a lot better. But anyway, thank you guys for hanging out. Appreciate it. I do have the Titans next week. I am 1-4, so I am slowly, my win percentage per year is going up. Total, not so much. But we'll get there. Joe Burrow is going to probably murder my defense. I allow 266 yards per game, and that's in 6 minute quarters. So their defense is not very good at the run. And I'm pretty spread out as far as offense goes. All right. Well, thank you guys again. Appreciate it. Have a good night. Have a good day. Whatever it is, have a good one, and I'll see you next time.